Bruce, you must have something really good too.
Of course I do. It's Bruce Danielson, and I guess I'm here to entertain you too.
Hello, this is Kermit Staggers, co-chair of Stop the Funding, and we want to thank Sioux Falls for the incredible support given our Stop the Funding petition drive. This petition effort is our last effort to stop the waste of $25 million of your money on a building we don't need when we need the money to fix our streets. We are asking you to join us for this weekend's drive-in, sign, or drop-off petition event at the 300 building, 300 North Dakota, just north of the main library, Friday evening from 6 to 9 p.m., and Saturday from 9 a.m. to 6 p.m. If you have petitions with 20 signatures or just one, bring them down because we need them all. Our eager team of notary publics will be ready to help you complete your petitions so we can get this wasteful building project stopped.
Hello, this is former Sioux Falls City Councilman Kermit Staggers, asking you to join me in supporting Janet Brecky for the at-large City Council position.
Hello, this is former Sioux Falls City Council member Kermit Staggers, asking you to join me in voting for Zach DeBoer for the City Council Central District in the runoff election this Tuesday, May 1st.
Hello, and welcome to another edition of USF Crosstalk. I'm Ronnie Hawkins, and today we have special guest with us, Dr. Kermit Staggers, who is a professor of political science and history here at the University of Sioux Falls, and also happens to be in a pretty big race for Sioux Falls mayor right now. So thanks for taking time out of your busy schedule to come see us this morning, Dr. Staggers.
Well, thank you very much, Ronnie, for having me here today.
Awesome. Well, we'll just get right into it. As you know, there were a lot of candidates running for mayor this year. We had six total. What set Kermit Staggers apart from the rest of the field?
Well, in running against six candidates, you have to stand out above everybody else. If you don't, you're not going to get into the runoff. And so the main thing I tried to emphasize is that I was concerned about trying to have less property taxes, less regulation, letting people have more of their own opportunity to go out and be successful in life. And I think that message played well because, after all, we did get in this runoff, and now we're running in the April 27th election.
Several months ago, I got a phone call from somebody that wanted to know how to get involved. They wanted to start running for city politics. And I guess the best way to get involved is simply start going to different political events. You know, if you're a Democrat, go to Democrat events. Republican, go to Republican events. And get to know people. That's probably the best way, is to circulate, and just making friends and things like that. Just, it's not very difficult to do, really.
Well, Councilor Staggers, please come forward. Kermit L. Staggers was elected as a Central District Council member in 2002 and re-elected in 2006. In 2012, Councilor Staggers was elected as an at-large city council member. Councilor Staggers most recently served as a member of the Land Use and Public Services Committee and Urbanized Development Commission. Councilor Staggers is being presented first with a plaque recognizing his public service as an at-large city council member from 2012 to 2016. And now, he's being presented with an encased American flag whose inscription reads, "In recognition of Kermit L. Staggers for his 12 years of dedicated public service and commitment to the city of Sioux Falls and its citizens." The American flag was flown outside Carnegie Town Hall on Tuesday, March 8, 2016. Please join me in thanking Councilor Staggers for his 12 years of public service.
It is now my honor and my pleasure to introduce you to the at-large district. That is the councilor who represents the entire city, no matter where they live, work, and play. His name is Councillor Kermit Staggers. Councillor Staggers?
Well, thank you very much for that introduction. And also thank you for all of you being here this evening. Very, very nice turnout. On these kind of events, sometimes it's hard to know how many people are going to show up. But it's obvious we have a lot of family members here, which is really nice to be able to see my colleagues' family members. And also my wife, June, is here. She's been very important in my political career, especially when it comes to campaign time. She's out there campaigning and doing all kinds of things. And then also my daughter, Ann Kristen. She's also very much involved in politics. But and being involved in politics like this, and also being on the city council, we get to know many people in the city itself. And sometimes a lot of people let us know who they are, too. It's not uncommon in downtown Sioux Falls, Hy-Vee, or wherever, for people to say something to me, how they appreciate me being on the council. Well, I appreciate their kind words, but, you know, to tell you the truth, I don't know who they are. But it's still very, very nice, because that's an indication of what kind of people we have here in Sioux Falls. Very kind people. And also, that's also a reflection of what the city itself as a whole is like. I've lived in many cities throughout my lifetime, and really, there's no city better than Sioux Falls. And the primary reason for that, of course, is the citizens here, all of you in this room, plus the rest of the citizens outside this town hall. Let me mention that it's wonderful that we live in such a nice city, because when I taught state and local government at the University of Sioux Falls, one of the things I would often say at the beginning of the class would be that, you know, what's the most impactful government on your life every day? And of course, many people would say, well, obviously, it's the national government. Well, because on the national news, that's all we hear about, isn't it? But once in a while, somebody would say, the state government in Pierre, especially when it's in session. But I told them, those two answers are not correct at all. The most impactful government on all of you tonight, and also throughout the city of Sioux Falls, is city government. Now, that's not very commonly mentioned. I'm not sure if you've ever heard that before. But think about it just for a moment. When you get up in the morning, what's the first thing you do? Well, you go to the bathroom, and you brush your teeth, and get prepared for going to work. What are you using? You're using water that was provided by the city of Sioux Falls. It wasn't provided by the national government, provided by the city of Sioux Falls. Then you, some of you in Sioux Falls, you get your breakfast, you have your toaster, and you put your bread in the toaster to prepare it. Well, in Sioux Falls, there are some residents of Sioux Falls that get their electricity from the city government. And then you go out to the car, start the car, drive out of the driveway onto the street. Well, I think we all know the streets are owned by who? Well, the city of Sioux Falls. So, and you drive to work. And there are probably other examples of how the city impacts you just as you're going to work. But there is a lot of truth to the statement that city government impacts citizens more than probably most of the governments. Well, now to help carry on the tradition of city government here in Sioux Falls, next week we're going to have four new people taking the oath of office as a city council member. And I know most of the four members, and I guess the one thing I can say right now is that I'm probably going to be watching Channel 16 a lot. This is going to be an interesting city council. There's no doubt in my mind. Having said that, it's going to be interesting. At the same time, I think it's very fair to say it's going to be a very good city council. So we have some good people following in our footsteps. And having said that, once again, I would hope that the new members of the city council would be treated as well as all of us on the city council right now. And having said that, thank you very much once again for coming.
Sioux Falls, that was Kermit L. Staggers, your city councilor at large.
During this last Sioux Falls mayoral election, we heard some unfortunate things said about Dr. Kermit Staggers. Some said he was just a grumpy old man who likes to vote no on everything. We're here to clear his name because that's simply not true. In fact, the Staggers we know likes to party!
Move it, move it. You like to move it.
My name's Bruce Danielson with Citizens for Integrity. I'm the I'm standing here with my new co-chair, Kermit Staggers, who is on the Stop the Funding campaign that we've started. And first off, I'd like to put this around Kermit's neck as our new co-chair.
Kermit Staggers would like to make an announcement about his future political plans.
It has been a wonderful time working on the city council, but also working in the state legislature as a state senator. So for approximately 20 years, I've been part of elected office. And I want to thank the citizens of Sioux Falls for allowing me to have this opportunity. It's been wonderful.